हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजे इंटीग्रेटिव। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 119। धर्मेंद्र चातुर, द इंटीरियर रेजिडेंट ग्रीवियंस ऑफिसर फॉर ट्विटर इन इंडिया, हैज क्विट। चातुर सक्सीड विद इन अ मंथ ऑफ इट्स अपॉइंटमेंट, लीव्स द यूएस बेस्ड माइक्रो ब्लॉगिंग प्लेटफॉर्म विदाउट अ ग्रीवियंस ऑफिशियल हु इज अ रेजिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया एज मैंडेटेड बाय इंडियाज न्यू आईटी रूल। चातुर, हु हैज ऑल्सो डिलीटेड हिज ट्विटर अकाउंट एंड ट्विटर डिक्लाइंड टू कमेंट। द सोशल मीडिया कंपनीज वेबसाइट डिस्प्ले द नेम ऑफ जेरेमे किसल, ट्विटर ग्लोबल लीगल पॉलिसी डायरेक्टर, एज अ डेसिग्नेटेड ग्रीवियंस ऑफिसर। India Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal has ratcheted up the heat on US e-commerce giants like Amazon and Walmart, accusing them of arrogance and of flouting local laws by indulging in predatory price plans. Goyal said companies were using their scale and access to large pools of low-cost capital to indulge in predatory price practices to the detriment of mom-and-pop stores. A number of large e-commerce companies that have come into India and very blatantly flouted the laws of the land in more ways than one, he told that on a virtual event late on Saturday. And he also mentioned that he had several engagements with these large companies, particularly the American ones, and he can also see a little bit of arrogance in them. 4G Team Deathmatch is finally available as a beta release. Developer and Core Games have earlier promised that beta version would be available on June 21st, but they missed the date. On Sunday, Encore Games posted a tweet announcing that 4G TDM mode beta release is now available for download. Although there are only limited slots available, this means you will need to download the early access version soon if you want a chance to try it out before the official release. Telegram has announced a couple of significant updates to its messaging client across different platforms. The first is a pretty significant upgrade to video calling, and other is to design and UI. The video calling side of things in Telegram is getting lots of new changes, many of which seem inspired by Apple's updates to FaceTime during Worldwide Developer Conference 2021. Telegram now gets a group video call support. Users have to initiate a group voice call, and then tapping the camera icon will automatically place you in a group video call. While there are no limits to the number of group voice call participants on Telegram, group video calls are now currently limited to 30 people. In addition to just sharing your camera feed, you can also share your screen with others on the video call. On smartphones and tablets, by default, your entire display is shared. On desktop, users have a choice of sharing the entire screen or a particular window. Telegram has also added an updated background noise suppression feature to voice chats. Like Apple, Telegram also now offers to turn this off if you want to send all the sound the microphone is capturing without any alterations. On tablets and desktop, video call feature large split screen view of the video grid along with the list of participants. Group video calls on desktop are also a separate window, so you can do other things without minimizing the video call. Aside from the video call features, Telegram is also adding several changes to its UI. There is now support for animated backgrounds, which is a first for the messaging application. The background features spinning color patterns which animate every time you send a message. You can choose your own colors and patterns through the settings. Telegram says that these are fairly light on resources, so they won't bog down your performance or consume too much of power. Animated backgrounds created by the user can also be shared with others. The message sending animation has also been updated, and the next emoji and stickers now smoothly glide upwards from the text box into the chat, similar to iMessage. Aside from these changes, there are also two new application icons on iOS: login into reminders, bot menu to browse the list of comments, and even more animated emoji. Telegram is now releasing tools for developers to create application that lets people generate custom unique stickers and import them to Telegram in one tap. Billions of times each year, people turn to Google web search box for help figuring out what's wrong with their skin. Now Google is preparing to launch an application that uses image recognition algorithms to provide more expert and personalized help. A brief demo at the company's developer conference last month showed the service suggesting several possible skin conditions based on uploaded photos. Mobile World Congress Barcelona brings next week, and it is expected that there will be several announcements. While some manufacturers have already made some early announcements, there is still a lot to look forward to. Here is what to expect next week in the tech. On June 28th, we are going to see Samsung Mobile World Congress virtual event. It is scheduled for June 28th as a date for its virtual event. There most likely won't be any product announcement, but Samsung will talk about the Galaxy ecosystem and new developments. On the same day, Lenovo also have an event on June 28th and it plans to discuss foldable devices according to the description on the Mobile World Congress website. Maybe we will hear or even see what Lenovo has planned for this new category of devices. Just like Samsung owns, this too will be a virtual event. Xiaomi has no plans to attend Worldwide Conference, but it has scheduled a product launch for the first day of the tech event. The launch is for the Mi TV 6, its flagship TV. The smart TV packs some pretty impressive features such as dual 48-megapixel camera and a 100-watt inbuilt speakers. And from July 1st, we gonna see some interesting products releasing from Dezo and Realme. Dezo and Realme plan to unveil a handful of products on July 1st. The former is the first brand under Realme TechLife ecosystem and it plans to announce its very first product on that day. But there is a high chance there will be more products. Realme, on the other hand, also has a handful of lifestyle products it has planned for release, some of which have already been listed on its website. Kindly check out the link mentioned in the description. And from TCL, we gonna see C-Series XR online launch event on 30th June on 12 PM onwards. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.